So, we are in the Teutoburger Forest in Bielefeld, Germany. It's the 13th of October, or 15th of October, 2017. And this is an interesting forest because there was a battle here, a decisive battle between the Romans and the Germans. And that's when the Romans pulled out of the Magna Germania. I'm here with Sarah and her second cousin, Catherine. So the Romans pulled out of the Magna Germania. That's because the Germans had a Roman-trained general, I believe, some high-ranking officer, who knew all the Roman strategies. So, we're on ground that there has been a lot of bloodshed. This is also a really good place to just rest in awareness of the sort of interdependent aggregation and the matrix of interdependency of all the factors we've seen in nature. We've seen a lot of mushrooms. There's a lot of underground mycelial networks interacting with the trees, which is always kind of a wondrous thing to think about. It's like they're the underground brain and we're the above ground brain. So it's quite beautiful here. It's good to just take a moment, really. Look around, and just get into this 270, 360 degree awareness mode. In the center of your body, just being aware of the surrounds without necessarily focusing on each individual part. And like really pulling your pelvic bone, your tailbone rather, downward towards the earth. Breathe deeply. Erect spine, suspended vertebrae. Notice how the mind categorizes things, right? It's all activity of the mind. I'm just going to walk a little bit further. What they're doing over there. Too bad, right? This is a 360 video. Something I like to do, oh look, here are some mushrooms. You can see some small ones right in front of me, or I'm facing. And there are some much, much bigger ones, and also some much smaller ones. Something I like to do is kind of push myself up against a tree and let the equal and opposite reaction just push down through my body into the earth. So feel how all the forces in my body are acting to kind of keep my body congealed together. So for example, I have the ground beneath me supporting me, gravity pushing me down, that's one force. If I push against the tree, that's another force, and then the force of the tree against me. And then I could do something interesting with that. I could let that force kind of feel like it's raining down like a waterfall through my body. And then instead of using muscular force to push against the tree, I just feel as if it's more into the fascial layers that's holding the tension. This is a posting, right? It's like a principle of internal martial arts. It's very useful to carry yourself this way as much as you can while you're deeply breathing. use nature to also reflect on the structure of the mind. So the leaves themselves are kind of like the crystallized, denser forms. And light that goes through them is kind of like the light of awareness, maybe. And so the dense forms reflect a certain kind of light, and those are more stable forms. But the light itself is kind of going through the spaciousness between all these dense forms. And there's a flow, kind of an open pathway there. So you can imagine like all your thoughts, all your emotions that you self-identify with as being a semi-stable structure of the mind is something that you can sort of undensify, if that's a word, liquefy, kind of make it more, less dense, and kind of sublimate your awareness, your awareness into the more spacious parts of mind, and then go back into the more dense parts, kind of a cycle between those. Color is another interesting aspect of perception. Color is, if you look at the visual cortex, color tends to easily be defined, or the properties of color in the visual system tend to be defined by the lines that border it. So the color is easily spreads. The way color is processed in the brain is kind of like a watercolor. It kind of bleeds around within a defined space, even if the color is only present densely in one part. So with regard to the forest, we have a lot of brown. It's autumn here in the northern hemisphere, so there's a lot of yellow. There's also a lot of green. So green, you can imagine like the color is a wash that permeates your external, your exteroception, right, your sensory space, outside of your body, but it also can permeate into your mind. So, and what I mean is actually use the nature to inspire almost like a feeling of color washing through your whole body, especially the center line of the body. So we're on some kind of a street. So I'm going to take a pause here and continue.